In the past few centuries, medical science has progressed rapidly. Today, advancements are even more rapid than 20 years ago, and their impact is just beginning to be understood. I'm Charlton Heston. This is American Medical Review.
Maddening, frustrating, terrible. Tinnitus. It's a sound in your head. It never goes away.
These are the sounds of tinnitus. And for over 50 million Americans, they are a part of everyday life. For about 12 million, it is a severe, nerve-wracking affliction that can make life unbearable to the point where sufferers even contemplate suicide.
I've had tinnitus since about 1980, and I acquired it through playing in a rock band for about 10 or 12 years prior to that. It's affected my life dramatically, both from both social, my home life, and my occupation, and primarily because I can't be exposed to loud sounds like I used to, because that'll make the tinnitus worse, the ringing worse.
Tinnitus is a condition in which a person hears sounds either in their ear or in the middle of their head, in which there's no external sound source. It can be clicking, buzzing, hissing, roaring, chirping, any number of sounds. Sometimes people have more than one sound. It's often the result of exposure to loud noise. It may be due to a disease process. It may just be due to an adverse reaction to a medication. Most physicians treat the disease that may cause the tinnitus, but often when the disease is treated, the only thing that is left is the ringing or the sound in their ears. The physicians then say, I'm sorry, you'll have to live with it.
Today, doctors can work with those suffering from tinnitus to determine the type and intensity of the condition and recommend methods to help relieve its effects.
There's a couple of different treatments that we have available that we're going to try with you today. One of them is an acoustic therapy in which we present other types of sounds that help hide or take the edge off of your tinnitus.
Acoustic therapy techniques include masking and retraining, or habituation therapy. These techniques utilize ear-level maskers, noise generators, hearing aids, and counseling.
We're concerned about your high-frequency hearing loss because that's precisely the region that you need to hear the masking sounds to cover up your tinnitus. Your tinnitus is also up here. This is a combination unit of both the hearing aid and a mask. With an arrangement like this, the tinnitus is under your control. You can determine when you will hear it and when you won't hear it, rather than the other way around.
That would be nice.
The nonprofit American Tinnitus Association has been the catalyst and sponsor for most of the research behind searching for the causes and hopefully finding a cure for tinnitus.
More recently, the research has began to investigate how the brain actually processes sound. And so we can compare how the brain transfers sound signals through it in normal patients and in people that have tinnitus. And we've started to see that there are differences. This is very exciting because it tells us another piece of the puzzle on where tinnitus is coming from and possibly how to treat it.
And high technology is being used to look at the problem in other ways.
And electron microscopy is a very good example in this laboratory. We have people here who are studying the autoimmune diseases that can affect hearing. With the electron microscope that we have in the back here, you can go down to a very fine level of resolution and find out exactly what's going on in that tissue to try to understand the underlying process, hopefully come up with some sort of treatment that will help that, perhaps arrest the condition.
Part of what we do is to try to provide enough information to people so that they have a hopeful attitude towards tinnitus, that they understand that there are things that they can do to get help, and that they make intelligent decisions about utilizing that help.
Tinnitus is an insidious condition that is growing in America. The loudness of our civilization is affecting us.
Advances in research and technology are constantly improving the lives of those who have to live with tinnitus. It is important that physicians are aware of these advances and join in the fight to find a cure. Hopefully, this may someday bring silence to those who live in a world where none exists.
Advancements like these give us hope for a healthier tomorrow. I'll see you next time on American Medical Review.